You know, I love you guys, right?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. And you know how much I love your mom?
Yeah.
Yeah? And so I want to ask you guys something.
Yeah.
I want to ask you guys permission if I could marry your mom. Yeah?
Yeah.
That's okay with you guys?
Yeah.
And are you excited?
Yeah.
So that's the surprise. That's why you guys are here. So your grandparents and your aunt and uncle, they're going to come too, okay? And you know when you ask someone to marry you, you know what you give them?
Ring.
Yeah, you give them a ring. You want to see the ring?
Yeah.
You guys like it?
Yeah.
You think your mommy will like it?
Yeah.
So she's not here yet. She's coming though.
Okay.
Okay. And then, so since your mom is getting a ring, I got you guys something too.
What?
I got you guys rings too. Yeah. This one's for you, Enzo. Luca, this one's for you. Yeah, open them up. So they may be a little big on you, but try them on. You can put on any finger you want. How's it fit? Yeah. So I got there's a chain in there in case you want to put it on as a necklace if it doesn't fit you.
No, I want it fun.
Yeah. Are you guys excited?
Yeah.
Can I have a big hug? Yeah.
Oh, I love you guys.
Yeah, uh-huh. You guys are coming to it, right?
Yeah.
Hey guys, my name's Lance, and right now my girlfriend Teresa is getting a stage 1 cancer tumor removed from the top of her chest. And I'm here with my buddy John, who's behind the camera. But what I'm gonna do now is go in and ask her dad if I can marry his daughter. So he's from Italy, and they've been here just for like this generation, so he doesn't speak wonderful English, and I don't speak any Italian, but I've been practicing over and over and over this phrase, may I please marry your daughter. So I'm really hoping it goes well. I hope I actually ask what I'm trying to ask. We'll see. But I think what I'm about to say is, posso prega di sposaria sua figlia. So I hope that translates well, and I hope he understands what I'm trying to say, because I'm in love with his daughter, and while she is getting surgery to remove the cancer from her chest, I'm going to ask her dad if I can marry her. So, wish me luck. Here I go. You've raised a wonderful daughter. Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah. And it's nice because I can say that, like, I'm honestly very much in love with your daughter.
Yeah, yeah. Never have a problem with me.
Never.
Not for trees, not for mom.
Yeah. You've raised some good girls.
Yeah.
It's fun when you guys all speak Italian.
Yeah.
I'm trying to like understand everything. It's difficult. Yeah, Italian's hard. I only know a little bit, but I've been practicing. Yeah, like
you know the problem. It's important to practice.
Yeah, you gotta practice. How is it?
I want to ask you something.
Yeah.
Yeah, ti posso chiedere qualcosa.
Oh gosh, that's difficult.
Ti posso chiedere, yeah.
Posso chiedere?
Posso chiedere.
Posso chiedere? So posso chiedere, like that?
Chiedere.
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 Posso chiedere?
Qualcosa, yeah.
So.
Okay, excuse me, think.
Posso chiedere?
Chiedere.
Posso chiedere. And does that mean may I?
Yeah.
Okay. So what is this sentence? Posso chiedere de
qualcosa.
Sposario sua figlia.
Oh, yeah. Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Did I say it right?
Yeah.
Excellent.
Yeah. Yeah. When I see my daughter happy, is she happy? Now she's
happy. She seems happy?
Before, no, think too much.
So
it's very, very hard.
Yeah. So did I say it right?
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah.
That was great. I wish you could have saw his reaction when he finally realized what in the world I was saying in Italian, but he said yes, and I'm very excited. So Teresa's still in surgery, but now I just talked to her father, and he gave me permission to marry his daughter, and I am ecstatic. So Now, I gotta tell her mom, his wife. I'll do that tonight. That'd be great too. This place? Right here?
Right here.
Oh, okay.
I was sitting over there.
Oh, well, you can sit here.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Aw. Well, I have something so we can feel more comfortable.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm. You ready?
What is that? I was gonna come in here, and if you were sitting down, I was gonna introduce myself.
Aw.
But you were waiting for me outside.
Yeah. Aw. It feels like not long ago we were here. We had 5 minutes. We got to ask each other all kind of questions and talk about our life experiences and get to know each other. And I was thinking that if someone told me that at the end of those 5 minutes, somebody told me that in a few months that I would fall head over heels in love with the person across from me at this table, I would have absolutely believed them. And we've had a lot of life experiences together now. I feel like, you know, we've gone to baseball games and Broadway shows, and we flew to Philly just for dinner.
I was just gonna say that.
And we went skydiving together.
On my birthday.
On your birthday. And we've been to birthday parties and been to a funeral and went to doctor procedures now. And had a lot of blood work done, and you've been poked and prodded, and you've gone through surgeries. That's a lot of...
And you've been there.
That's a lot of life experiences. But you keep saying this line that of how I didn't sign up for this, and how I didn't sign up to be dating someone who has cancer, and I don't like that you keep saying that. So I brought something. And this is a sign-up sheet.
What is it?
This is an official sign-up contract agreement. So I'm gonna read it to you, okay?
Okay.
It says, I, Lance Svensson, being of sound mind, hereby sign up to be in a relationship with Teresa Molinaro. I'm signing up for a relationship that will involve ups and downs, that will be joyful and fun, exciting and amazing, one that will involve the good times, yet also through the tough times, one through both good health and the challenges, through the times where one of us feels weak or insecure and the others can pick them up and carry them if needed, one that still makes me lose my train of thought when you walk into a room, one where I have trouble breathing just by looking in your eyes. Now it is agreed as followed that I am irrevocably signing up for you to be the one I look forward to seeing each day, to be the one I make sure is taken care of, to be the one I make sure has plans for dinner each night, to be the one who I get to drive next to holding hands, to be the one who gets to plan your birthday parties, to be the person I plan holidays with and make traditions with, to be the one to kill bugs for, to change light bulbs for, to reach things on the high shelves for, to be the one that I worry about when you're driving in the rain, to be the one who gets to take care of you when you're not feeling well, and be the one who gets to make jokes to try and make you smile. Now, no modifications or amendment to this contract shall release the guarantor from its liability under this contract. As someone who makes a lot of contracts, I think you understand the severity of this.
Yeah.
Mostly, I sign up for a life where I am absolutely, positively, completely, unconditionally, and perfectly in love with you. And look, it's signed.
I signed it.
So that this is now an official document. Deal? So now you can't say it different.
Okay.
Deal?
I love you.
Aw. I love you.
My God.
So not long ago, we sat here and we had 5 minutes. And after that 5 minutes, we both said yes. And... And 3 weeks ago, while you were getting surgery to get the tumor removed, I asked your dad a question. And earlier today, I drove up and I asked your son's question. So I have one more question. I'm not that brave though.
Oh my god.
Through small and narrow. Will you marry me?
Yes.
Yeah.
Congratulations. Welcome to our family, Tim.
And I knew that this was our first date, and this was the table we sat at. And then this was good, the contract, because I did keep saying to you, you didn't sign up to date a girl who got sick. So I thought this was just like reassuring me before the next step.